Bhavya, I unmuted you. Good morning. Please tell me, am I audible? Okay, am I visible? Board is visible or not? Okay, wait. Now show thumb, please. Now your show thumb, is my video or the voice audible? Bhavya, do you hear me? Please show thumb if the video is visible. Okay, Bhavya, I'm just going to unmute you. Yes. Yes, okay, what's wrong? Okay, you just give me the answer. Okay, video is visible. Okay, wait a minute. Please lower your hand. Lower your hand first. Wait, please lower your hand first. I'll give you time, okay, in the end. And after that, you can clear your doubt, okay? So, very good morning to all of you. So, my dear students, I hope you all are fine and doing great. Okay, and yesterday was your English revision test. And I'm sure that you all have done well. Okay, suppose if you have any doubt or any questions regarding that, okay, I'll give you time at the end. Okay, then you can clear your doubts. Okay, so first, what we are going to do? Yes, today we are going to revise our topic. So first the topic which we are going to revise, yes, lesson number 9. Look at the board, that is lesson number 9, foxcatchers, and we'll discuss extra question answers. Okay, that these question answers will help you to understand the chapter thoroughly. Okay, so you know what I'll do first? Okay, I'll tell you the brief summary of that chapter. Okay, so here I start. So my dear students, we all know that the water, which is very much essential, okay, which is very much essential for our survival, it's being depleted at a very fast pace. Okay, so what should we do? Yes, so it is our duty to find out about or to experiment the other sources of fresh water. Okay, so how can it be done? So my dear students, there are, okay, so both have the potential to provide an alternative source of fresh water. And how it can be harvested? Yes, the fork can be harvested with the use of simple and economical device. Okay, so my dear students, so what is fork catching? Yes, fork catching is an invention, okay, which serves to trap the water droplets from fog. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, now the question is, what are the fog catchers? So, my dear students, fog catchers are the simple structures of double or interlined mesh, okay, which are supported on two poles and that are connected to the ground. Okay, so my dear students, I hope it is clear to you. Now the question is, how are they used to collect water? Yes, it's very simple. You know what happens? So high winds push the fog through the mesh, and the water droplets get trapped in it. You know what happens? Yes, the water droplets chocolate yet contains antrical sound trap, which is connected to a bigger tank, okay, which holds the water. So my dear students, and this collected water further can be used, okay, for various purposes like agriculture or for domestic purposes. So it is very much clear that two things are very much important or necessary, okay, for the better water collection. Okay, that is one. It is high humidity, and second is first is large droplets of water, and the second is the wind or the humidity. Okay, so my dear students, so it means the four factors can work best. Okay, where have the dense fog for considerable period of time. Okay, so one more thing. So what kind of areas are good for it? Yes. So for this project, so coastal areas are very much suitable. And you know why? Because humidity level is high and the wind, they push the fog towards the land. I hope it is clear to you. One more thing, my dear students, is this fog capping phenomena. It's not a new process. Okay, so what the archaeologists or the scientists have found out that the basic stone structure, okay, for harvesting water from the air already existed in ancient Israel or the Egypt. Okay, so one more thing, that is, you know what? So all countries got attracted towards this phenomena. Okay, and one more thing. So in the country Morocco, you know one thing, world's largest fog catching project. Where is it? Yes, it is in Morocco. And who runs it? Yes, a woman led and you run it. And it has been spread over 600 square meter. Now this technology or this technique, okay, have become good for the villages and attracted regions in Morocco. And how it has become good? Very simple, because you know what? Earlier women had to walk for 3 to 4 hours, okay, to the distant wells to carry water for domestic purposes or for households. It was very tough, and you know what happened? Now this technique not only saves their time, but their energy also. Time and how? You know what? Earlier they have to pay more for the water truck when the wells would come. Okay, so now it saves their time, their energy, and the cost is very low. Okay, so but you know what, my dear students? Every coin has two sides. In the same way, this technology has shortcomings also. So what are the shortcomings? Okay, so first is that it depends on the source of water, which is not always available. And the second one, you know what? The dryness in the air, okay, can cause the humidity to evaporate even before it trickles down. But still, we can say that this project or this technique has worked with considerable success. Okay, and if implemented properly, it could go a long way in reversing the depleting level of fresh water on the surface of the earth. Okay, and last but not least, this object can be seen or may be seen in the coastal areas as a common object. So I hope this chapter, the summary is very much clear to you. Okay, you have got to know about the new technique. Yes, the new project is fog catchers, and we have got to learn that we should conserve the water. Okay, so now it's your turn. So what I'm going to do? Yes, I'm going to ask you some extra question answers. So get ready. So first question we have, that is, why is it necessary to find about the other sources of water? Why do we have these? Okay, so I'm going to give turn to राधिका, राधिका, I have unmuted you, बच्चे, please give me the answer. Oh, Radhika, your answer is very good. Very good, Shabash. Big clap for you, dear. Great. Okay, so now my next question is, how can oats be harvested? How can oats be harvested? Now I'm going to give turn to, Bhavya. Bhavya, I have just unmuted you, dear. Please give me the answer. Very good, Bhavya. Excellent, marvelous. Shabash, okay. Keep it up. Now, please, what I'm going to do? I'm just going to mute you all. Okay. So now my next question is: in which area fox statue work best? This is the easiest answer. Okay. So I'm going to give turn to Prithanya. You please, I'm just going to mute you. Give me the answer, okay? Okay, yes, Your voice Okay, no water. And what that area should have? Okay, Kritagya, I just make you correct. Your answer is correct, but it can be given like this, right? Fox statues can work best in the coastal areas. Why? Because the humidity level is high and the wind push the fox towards the land. Okay, I hope it is clear. And one more thing, they can also work best in those areas where have fox for considerable period of time. Is it clear? Okay. So now I'm going to give turn to. So next we are going to discuss word meanings. Okay. So I have selected one word. Okay, that is afflicted. The word is afflicted. Now you have to give me the meaning. Okay. So I'm going to give turn to. Angel, please. I have just unmuted you, bache. Please give me the answer. What is the meaning of afflicted? Yes. Very good. Excellent. Keep it up. Shabash. So next, okay. Next we are going to discuss another thing. Okay. Okay. The next topic we are going, that is back exercise. And one more thing, I want to make it clear, my dear students, what you have to do? You have to learn vocabulary, which is given at page number 96. Okay? What is smoke? What is dew? What is mist? What is snow? It can come by two ways, right? You can be given like fog. What is fog? You have to tell the answer. One more thing. Now, the statement will be given to you. Then you have to give the one word. Like, I'm going to give the example. That is rain. So what is rain? A liquid form of water that falls from the sky. Okay. So, it can come like this. So, liquid form of water that falls from the sky falls. What? Yes, obvious rain. Okay. I hope it is clear to you. Now, let's discuss another. So, tiny ice crystal on a cold surface is called what? Hail or frost? So, I'm going to give turn to, Mehak. I have just unmuted you, but please give the answer. Very good morning. Yes, it's called frost. Okay, So I hope it is clear to you. Now let's discuss the grammar topic. The first topic we have is fill in with main verb. Okay, so you know what? First I'll discuss with you what is verb. So my dear students, verbs are the action words. Okay, one more thing. This verb of the sentence can ask what the subject is, does or has. Okay, so there are two types of verb. First is main verb and the second is helping verb. What is the main verb? That functions alone in the sentence to make its meaning clear. Okay, like this. I'm going to give you an example. That is, I brush my teeth daily. So what do I do? Yes, brush. That is a verb. Okay, so brush is the main verb. Okay, so next we have helping verb. So we have correct form of be. Okay, do you remember present form of be? That is is, am, are. Past form of be was, was. And have, that is the present form. Had is the present form of ever have. And do, does, present form of do. And did is the past form of do. These all are helping verbs. So once more is helping verb, that is model auxiliary. So what are model auxiliaries? Yes, these are the special groups of verbs. Special groups of auxiliary verbs. Okay, and they are used to convey meaning like permission, suggestion, and request. And one more thing, that is to indicate the future tense. And I'm sure you have got to know. Yes, these are can, could, will, would, may, might, shall, should, etc. Okay, so now it's your turn. Okay, so I'm going to, okay, I've written few sentences. What you have to do, you have to write first. Fill in the blanks with main verb. Okay, so helping verb comes with the main verb. Okay, that helps the main verb to clear the meaning. But main verb functions alone. Okay, it does not need anybody else. Okay, so here I start. The sun dash in the east. Now you have to fill this blank by using the main verb. Okay, so I'm going to give turn to, yes, that is Raghav. Raghav, I have unmuted you. Okay, look at the board. So first sentence is the sun dashed in the east. Now you have to fill this blank by using main verb. Okay, yes, the sun set in the east. No, sun does not set in the east. Sun rises in the east. Raghav, what are you doing? You are a very good student. And don't you know the meaning of rise and set? So the sun rises in the east. I hope it is clear to you. Okay. So one more thing I want to know, Raghav. You just raise your hand when the meeting just started. So what is your doubt? Do you want to ask something from me? No, then why you raise your hand? Please, all the students listen. Okay, when the meeting starts, you are not supposed to raise your hand. If you have any doubt, I'll give you a turn. Okay, so you will take your turn and you can ask any questions. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to mute you on first. So now we have next, that is I dash football daily. I dash football daily. So I'm going to give turn to, yes, that is Divya. Divya, I've unmuted you, but please give me the answer. I dash football. So it's very simple. You have to fill this blank. Very good. Excellent. Excellent. Big clap for you. Very good, Shabash. So next we have, very good, Bikin. Okay, so next, what I'm going to discuss with you, another topic, that is underline the helping verb. So helping verb, they always help. Helping verb, yes, they help. And yes, they help the main verb, the base meaning. So my dear students, what I have done, written few sentences. The first one, that is, she is singing a sweet song. Now here you have to find out the helping verb. Okay, I'm going to give turn to that is Komal. Komal, I am unmuted you, bache. Please give me the answer. Which word is verb? Is. Very good. Excellent. This is the present form of be that tells us how the people, okay, or things or animals is are now. Okay? I hope it is clear to you. Very good. Excellent. So next we have, welcome Ravachya, please. Now mute yourself. Okay? So next we have, okay, so now look at the next sentence. They will fly kites. They will fly? They will fly kites. Now you have to identify the helping verb. So I'm going to give turn to, yes, Muskan. Muskan, I have unmuted you, but please give me the answer. They will fly kites. Very good, excellent. So whale or shell, that's a helping verb. Okay, they tell us that an action or an activity is going to be happening in the future. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, now let's move ahead. Okay. Okay. So next we are going to discuss models. So I just told you that models are a special group of personalities that are used to convey certain meaning, like permission, suggestion, possibility, presentability, or you can say polite request, and number of models. Okay, are there? Okay. So first is I just ran very fast when I was young. Okay. Before you give the answer, you have to read this sentence. Okay. You have to be particular, or you have to look at this word. This is verb. So this shows that the sentence is in past tense. So this sentence shows that somebody was able to do something in the past. Okay, so I dash run very fast when I was young. So I'm going to give turn to, okay, so I'm going to give turn to the Harman. Harman, please, I want to give you a chance. Give me the answer. Very good morning. How are you, Harman? Okay, this one is correct. One more model. Okay, used to show the past habit. I used to run very fast when I was young. One more model can be used here. Can you get that? Try. Yes, good. Okay. So model could is used to show past ability. That is that tells us that somebody was able to do something in the past. Okay. I hope it is clear to you. So have a big clap for you, bache. Excellent. Keep it up. Okay. So next, I'm going to read another sentence. That is you dash wear mask. Great. So I think you already know the answer. So you dash wear mask when you go outside. Okay. So I'm going to. So it is a suggestion. Okay. So for suggestion, we always use. So I'm going to give turn to Natansh. Natansh, I have unmuted you, bache. Please give me the answer. You dash. You. You, sorry, but I have not got it. Please give me the answer. Okay, you must wear mask when you go outside. Okay, very good, excellent. Okay, so it's so provision. Okay, one more thing can be used. Yes, okay, so must is appropriate. Okay, so now I'm going to discuss with you. Okay, so I'm going to participate. Okay. So my dear students, what you have to do, you must wear mask when you go outside. You should wash your hands. Okay. After intervals between the fingers. Okay. And one more thing, you should not eat junk food. You should take exercise. Take adequate water. Okay. I hope you are all doing all these things. It's okay. Now let's move ahead and let's discuss another topic, that is subject verb agreement. So my dear students, before we do this, we need to understand what is subject. Yes, subject is a doer. Okay, so subject tells us what the sentence. Okay, so subject is the doer who performs action. And what is the verb? The action verb. So there is a connection between two. Yes. So some verb must agree with the subject. Like, okay, I don't like him. Next, she does not like him. So have you noticed the difference? Yes. I with I, we, you, they, we use. Yes, we use that only the first form. And with third person singular, we always use he, or we always use as with the first form. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. So now we'll discuss this topic, that is subject verb agreement. So Sabrina and Meena, that friends. So I'm going to give turn to yes, Mahi. Mahi, I have unmuted you, bache. Please give me answer. Yes, Reena dash Meena are friends. Very good. And you know what? So, my dear student, then two or more subjects are connected with and, then we always use verb. Yes, plural verb. Okay, like Rohan and Rohan dash friends. Our friends. Okay, they dash two schools together. Four both? Yes, they go to school together. Okay, so next I'm going to discuss with you another sentence, that is she dash a verb regularly. Oh, that some regularly shows us that somebody does her work on regular basis. It's her habit. Okay, for habitual actions, we always use yes first form, and the first form indicates the simple present tense. And when we have present tense, when we have third person, he, she, it. So I'm going to give turn to. Okay. So I'm going to listen to what the others are doing. Gauri, Gucharan, Manish, Muskan, Neza, Jasri, Pavni, Raghav. Are you not sleeping? Okay. So I'm going to give turn to. Oh, Adhika, you haven't raised your hand. What's the reason, bache? So I'm going to give turn to. Okay. Wait, I'm going to give turn to Radhika. Radhika, I have unmuted you, bache. Okay, she dash her work regularly. Do or does? She? Yes. Oh, that's right. Why have you given the answer? Why have you given this? Not the right option. Yes, okay, now I'll make you understand. Why do we use? Look, she does her work regularly. So regularly, generally, often, always, that indicates the present tense. So when we have present tense, we always use first form. Okay, so when we have to use first form, we have to keep in mind two things. Okay, so if the subject, that is she, is a singular, third person singular, he, she, it, any noun, any name, then we always use, okay, so we always use this. So we use as with the first form. So she does her work regularly. Okay, suppose they dash their work regularly, then, okay, now you tell what will be the option. Do or does? They dash their work regularly. They do their work regularly. Okay, my dear students, I hope everything, the topics and the everything is clear to you. Now it's your turn. Okay, now first you all lower your hand, and now those two students will raise their hand if they have any kind of problem. Okay, so I'm going to give turn to Okay, term Bhavya. Bhavya, have you any doubts with it? Bhavya, I have unmuted you. Please tell if you any doubts. Yes, Bhavya, you tell if you have any doubts. Okay, but it is here, that's fine. Okay, so I'm going to give turn to Mehak. Mehak, I have unmuted you, bachche. Please tell, you have raised your hand if you have any doubt. Okay, look, you have to write the answer. The thought of going to school makes the child sad. Why? Because he's not willing to go to school. What does he want to do? He wants to play. Okay? I hope it is clear to you. Okay, that's it. Make the child sad. Take all the joy away. Because he is not willing to go to school, he wants to go outside and play. Okay? I hope it is clear to you. Oh, be like a bird. Okay? He wants to free. Okay? So I hope it is clear to you. Okay, my bachcha. Next. Okay. So next we have Mehak Hoda. Then we have Divya. Divya, I have unmuted you, bachcha. So I've given you turn. Now you can take your turn and please ask questions if you have any doubts. Very good morning. Yes. Of course, I told you now. Please lower your hand if you don't have doubt. Would you not lower your hand? See, anyhow, that's great if you have no doubt. Okay, it makes me feel good because you all are attentive and listening to me very carefully. So Komal, I'm just going to give you a turn, Komal. Yes, Komal. Komal, I have unmuted you, okay? So Komal is not responding, so I'm going to give turn to Pritigya. Pritigya, I have unmuted you. If you have any doubts, then you can discuss. Yes? Yes? No, you are not supposed to do that exercise, okay? That's not your job. It's clear? Okay, welcome, bachche, welcome. So next I'm going to give turn to, okay, Bhavya, I have given you turn, bachche. Okay, I have unmuted you. Okay, please. Bhavya, what's your doubt? I'm waiting. Okay. Yes. Yes, okay. I have unmuted you. Yes. Okay, here. Okay, but what for any topic? Any topic can come in your exam. Sorry, not okay. I'll just explain. So when you have to write the content, first line you always have to write like I am really sorry. Then second, you have to mention the reason why are you feeling sorry. Okay, so you can write like this. So yesterday I talked to you rudely. Or yesterday I something whatever done. Okay, so first you have to sorry, then you have to mention the reason, and after that you have to promise to make sure that no, that you are not going to repeat that mistake. And the fourth one, that is always again say sorry. Okay, so suppose you talk to your friend very rudely yesterday. So how will you write sorry? Okay, so first you will say, I'm really sorry Second, you will say, yesterday I talked to you very rudely. You know what? My mood was very upset. Okay? So, I promise I'm not repeating again. I'm feeling so bad for you. Okay? So, please forgive me. Ask for forgiveness. Please forgive me. Okay? And after that, what you always have to say? Sorry once again. Okay? You can also write like this. I shall not repeat this again. Okay, I hope it is clear, Bhavya. Okay, so next Muskan. Muskan, what's your doubt with it? Yes. Okay, listen. Poet compared himself to a bird. You know why? Because he feels that as the caged bird is not able or cannot sing, the caged bird can, as the caged bird cannot sing a sweet song in the same way. The boy who is forced to sit in the class or who is forced to learn something cannot be able to show his talent or cannot be able to do something to do his best. Is it clear? So my dear students, page number, it's not about the page number. So I'm discussing with you. So why he's comparing himself to a bird? Actually the bird is born feel free, okay? So in the same way he feels that I am born to feel free, okay? So he says that as a bird, caged bird cannot sing sweet song, in the same way he cannot do his best if he is forced to do something. If he is forced to sit in the class, he is not able to learn anything. I hope it is clear to you. Okay? So please use your own wording, okay? Develop your own line. Don't copy, don't write anything. Use your own mind. Why something is being done, how it's being done, okay? So this is how you can bring your own answers. Okay? So next I'm going to give turn to Angel Feet. Okay, but Angel Feet, I have unmuted you. Angel? Angel, do you have no doubt? That's very good on your part. It means everything is clear to you. So my dear students, I hope, okay, the chapter and the topics are very much clear to you. Please do practice, okay? So whatever you do in the class, do practice at home, okay? So I am sure that you are very good students. And one more thing you have to keep in mind, again I'm repeating, what? Always wash your hands, okay? Then wear your mask, okay? When you go outside, and avoid going outside until it is very much necessary, okay? And what you have to do, take plenty of water. Okay, then eat balanced diet, take nutritious food, and what you want to avoid is taking junk food. Okay, so you have to. Okay, one more thing: when you go outside and you see crowd, so what you have to do? You have to maintain distance, social distancing to be maintained. I hope you will act upon my advice and keep you safe at home. Okay, so with this. Okay, so I don't find any kind of doubt. So no hands. Okay? So I'm going to end this meeting here.